Hi everyone, today I am going to do a DIY at home foot spa. This is a mini unboxing of a foot basin / soap foot basin. You can buy a very ordinary basin, that will be fine. This is just a gift for our family, that's why I'm using it, and it's really good. So now, after adding water on the maximum level, we are going to add 1/2 cup of Epsom salt. I bought mine in Amazon, it's very cheap. And then next will be... Oh, that takes too long. Okay, 5 drops of any body oil that you want. That's my husband's hand helping me out, making my foot spa at home. Next is the peppermint oil. I mean, essential oil. 5 drops of it. You can use any essential oil that you want. I like the peppermint because it's relaxing, the minty smell. And then we can turn it on for bubbling. It also, it heats the water, but since it's so noisy and my children are still sleeping, I'm just gonna pour hot water to make a warm one. So it's up to you how warm you like. So touch it before you use it. You don't want too hot, you don't want it cold. So there. There, perfect temperature. My feet is ready. Okay, there you go. So soak your feet in 15 minutes. And then scrub it like that. Yeah. And then you can turn on that bubbly effect. But since it's noisy, we'll turn it off. Now 15 minutes is done. I am going to scrub it with a body scrubber, shampoo, or whatever you have there. It's very good if you have like a little beads on it. It massages your feet well. Now I have a foot scraper for my dead skin cells over there in my heel. Scrub, 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 scrub. Yeah. Scrub, 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 scrub. Yeah. I bought mine in Shein. I don't know how you pronounce that. Look. Because of my hard skin, I broke it. Now I'm done. I am going to pat dry and... I mean, just wipe it with towel and then rinse it with cold water. So I'm gonna go to the bathroom and wash it. Now the perfect time to clean your nails is when they're wet. So I'm using a cuticle moisturizer, a nail scraper, and of course nail cutter. So yeah, see, looks better. Woo! Look at that baby, look at that baby, look at that baby, Now I am going to use an exfoliating socks. This is really good in softening your heels and your hard skins on your foot. If you can get rid of them using your foot scraper, or if you're tired of just scraping your heels, this will soften them, and then after that it's easier to just peel them off. So this takes an hour, but since I'm so tired doing it by myself, I think I only put it on my feet for about 15 minutes, but the recommended time is 60 minutes. So there, it's like a socks. You just put a tape on it, everything is there. I bought mine in Ross. There's a lot of good things in Ross, Marshall, JCPenney. Oh, sorry, ripped that. Look at that shiny, dewy feet. Hey. Yeah, feet, because the other looks like that too. Look at that. Whee, shiny. So, yeah, it really smells not very good, but, you know, acceptable. And now the star of the show. This is from Purity. This is given to me for free to try. So, it's a foot cream. So instead of just trying it alone, I thought of doing a complete at-home foot care, because I think it'll be better that way. So I'm now unboxing it, and it has a seal, which is very good. I really like products that are sealed, because it puts trust on the customers. It means that nobody else touches it, and it's clean, you know. There, I'm opening it, and ta-da! Smells good. Really smells good. And let's try it on. Ooh! Wow! Feels good. It's not sticky. Feels refreshing. It's really good to the skin. Look at that leather. That smoothly. Oops! Dropped some. That's okay. It's really good. Yay! That's the aftermath. Thank you, Purity. Goodbye, guys. Mwah.